is our strength. The joy of the Lord is our strength. And when it touches you, you just feel it.
It
has touched
you.
Am I communicating? Falling, it's not bad. But if it's the mindset of how we explain the power of God, it's bad. Can I explain it? Falling is not bad. Falling is not bad. Can I explain it? Falling is not bad. But if that's the mentality that we're built, of how we can understand the power of God, it's wrong. The power of God comes to uplift men and give them a position. The power of God comes to uplift men from nonsense to somebody. From zero to hell. From desert into the palace. That's the power of God. That's the power of God. So the power of God comes to uplift us in any ways, financial, spiritual, physical, which are material things, money, not money, properties, cars, the way you put on. The grace of God changes you. Am I communicating? But if you understand the power of God by the number of people that are falling, that's wrong. I repeat it. That's wrong. If the church, we don't have tangible testimonies, even though we all fall, there's no power of God. What defines the power of God is the testimony. Can I go deeper? What defines the power of God is the testimony. Paul fell once and he became an apostle. And he is the one of the apostles. Not even the apostles only. But the man that wrote the Bible, he is the only man who wrote many books in the Bible. There are like 80 books. 80 books for Paul. Yet he did saw Jesus face to face. But he fell once, and the power of God entered into him. The language of the light entered into him. Immediately became the spiritual being walking on the earth. May the power of God fall upon you.